let's go right. Hey, good morning. It is 8:35 in the morning. It is, I think, a whopping 18 degrees. I hope for a little bit better weather, but that doesn't really matter that much. Let's put back on the Garmin, because at least it's dry. And now you're wondering, what are we gonna do today? If you read the title, you already know. Today we'll go to the motorport dealer where BMW is to celebrate the anniversary of the GS. And basically what they do, they have all the different GS. Hey, good morning. It is 8:35 in the morning. It is, I think, a whopping 18 degrees. I hope for a little bit better weather, but that doesn't really matter that much. Let's put back on the Garmin, because at least it's dry. Nope.
In the afternoon.
So we're now on our way to Goes. Ja, inderdaad. Het is in ieder geval droog, dat scheelt. So today I will be riding the R1250 GS Adventure and the R90 GS, so that's the... Ja, inderdaad. Het is in ieder geval droog, dat scheelt. So today I will be riding the R1250 GS Adventure and the R90 GS, so that's the scrambler version. And my brother, you will be riding the 850 GS Adventure, I think, and something else. We'll see. The way to Goes is mostly highway and nationals, but yeah, nationals in the Netherlands are almost the same as the highway because speed limit is 100.
Highway We're done with the highway and the nationals. Unfortunately, I forgot to turn on my helmet cam, so I have to do with the voiceover. Motorport's almost next to the highway, and I can already see the BMW stand on my right-hand side.
If you look through the trees, you can see the sign for Motorport.
So I'm really looking forward to the R1250 GS Adventure. Compare it to my own bike and actually see how much difference almost 25 years of innovation makes. On my right hand side you will see a lineup of all the GSs that BMW brought out for the event, and they're all the anniversary colors. And as a second bike we will be riding the R9T Urban GS, so looking forward to that as well.
And on the right you see a close-up of all the bikes. And just another pause because they're way too beautiful.
Cruise control. That's nice. Look, no hands. And especially if you do maybe do a tour somewhere or you're gonna rent a bike and this one is available, it's really nice to ride it.
Yes, it's the same shot. Here we're leaving and somehow some of the footage corrupted and I had some issues with the GoPro. The next videos I will take you along with the R1250 GS Adventure and the R9T Urban GS. I really liked both of the bikes, but the 1250 Adventure really was my favorite. Already spoiling a little bit the next video, but okay. So we rode both of the bikes for about 45 minutes, just doing a 40K loop. And actually, I didn't mess around with a lot of the electronics, so I don't know how much difference that will make. But one of the features I really liked on the Adventure was the quick shifter. So that's definitely something I'm gonna look into if I can retrofit that on my own bike, on Red Rhino. I haven't looked into the options yet, but we'll see if that's possible or not. And also the 1250 GS Adventure, such a big bike, shouldn't be that easy to ride and shouldn't be that fast. Really blew me away. For me, it was the first time doing such a kind of event, and I'm definitely gonna do a few more of those in the future. One of the next ones will be Harley Davidson, and then we'll see next year if there are some more of these kind of tours or events. I'm definitely going to check them out. Now we're gonna head home. First we're gonna find something to eat and fuel up somewhere. So sit back and enjoy.
Ah, die quickshift is wel goud.
Ja, we zijn wel tof.
Hé, oude GS.
Ja, die is nog ouder dan die van jou.
Nee, die is net zo oud. Ja, die is hetzelfde. Zo was ook een 1100.
Nee.
Maar ik weet niet welk jaar, want ze hebben maar een paar jaar volgens mij die gele gemaakt. Nou, hij was ooit geel die net langs reed.
Ja.
Net zo goed als die van mij ooit rood was.
Oh ja, daar is die gewoon beige. Ja, die van jou is gewoon bij de rolls.
Oops. Something didn't go according to plan.
So we found our lunch spot. A little bit of a late lunch, but doesn't matter. We're gonna eat some fish and chips. We're back in a little bit. It's actually near the harbor, so on my left side you will see some fishing boats. So the fish is absolutely fresh. Or should be. So as you guessed by now, I didn't have any footage of the lunch. But I will keep that in mind for next time. Live and learn. So we're heading home now. Last bit will be highway, not that interesting. I really had a lot of fun today. Spent some time with my brother. He rode the 850 Adventure. It's almost as high as the 1250 Adventure. I think it only is 5 millimeters difference, but it has a little bit less power. And his second bike was the 310 GS, which is the smallest GS bike. I've also ridden that for a little bit. All in all, really nice day. I hope you enjoyed this video. You can find the link to the dealer tour below. If you have any questions, let me know, and I will see you the next time. Bye.